You know, helping others is the Minnesota way of life. And that's what one Maple Grove family was unexpectedly called on to do. They had to decide whether the accidental death of their loved one would mean a new beginning for someone else. That family shared their story with our 5 Eyewitness News meteorologist Ken Barlow. And Ken, you found this is a terribly sad story, but also inspirational.
Yeah, and this family actually shared the story in some uplifting words. They were born from an upsetting event. Nithya Shankar is now a widow. She wanted to talk with us with hopes that her family's story will encourage others to talk about organ donation too.
These headlines make public Nithya Shankar's private pain.
If something has to happen to you, it can happen within minutes, and that's exactly what happened.
She watched from shore as one moment her husband went swimming with their children at Elm Creek Pond in Maple Grove. The next, he struggled in the water, slipping below the surface. Lifeguards pulled Shankar Vaishwanathan to the beach, but it was too late. He passed away in front of his family in the blink of an eye.
That's called a life-altering situation. You know, everything changes.
Her head reeling and heartbreaking, Mayo doctors gave Nithya 24 hours, just one day, to make a decision that could affect the lives of dozens of other people.
These are things you never think about it unless and until you're faced with that situation.
Would Shankar want to be an organ or tissue donor? During their 12 years of marriage, Nithya says they didn't get around to talking about it. Knowing her husband as an adventurous, selfless man who made a lasting impression on people, she felt compelled to continue his legacy.
It's a good feeling. It's very fulfilling to know that, you know, he's helpful to people even though he's not here physically.
Two dozen people so far have benefited from Shankar's contribution as a tissue donor. It's comforting for Nithya to know and one day tell their two young daughters that the best of their dad lives on through them. And 24 others.
What a noble deed their dad has done, you know, helping everybody. So that's something I would definitely talk to my kids about.
And Nithya wants her children to know that mom wants to be an organ donor too when that time comes. Her daughters are only 4 and 8 right now, but when they get older and the time comes, they'll have that conversation. She hopes that her story might kind of give others a little nudge to kind of think about it. It's a hard conversation to have.
Certainly.
But it's one that obviously is doing good for so many other people.
And this is one that really hits home for you on a personal level.
Yeah, well, we were confronted. My brother passed away 2 years ago in a car accident. He was an organ donor on his license,
right,
which you can do here as well.
Yep.
But it does bring up the whole topic of what do you do, how do you do it? And a Life Source was just an amazing help. His contribution, let's say, has helped now 50 people. So yeah, it goes on and on.
An important conversation to have. Right now, there are 2,800 people who are waiting for a life-saving transplant just here in Minnesota. Life Source at Mayo Clinic tells us that one person can save and heal up to 60 lives through the gift of organ or tissue donation. So to make your wishes known, you can indicate your choice on a driver's license, an ID card, or on Facebook. You could also announce you're a donor by heading to donatelifemn.org. We've posted all the information for you and the link on our website. You'll find everything you need on KSTP.com.